My name is Brooke.
And I'm Cade.
Welcome to GIS News.
In this episode, go behind the scenes to see what's cooking in our own GIS cafeteria.
Check out the cutest Valentine's gifts for your loved ones and stay tuned for the Jefferson Field Trip in 2020 GIS Science Fair.
Hi, I'm Arkayla with GIS News, and I'm here to tell you, Valentine's Day is just around the corner. Make sure you get a valogram for that special friend, special teacher, or special one. Here I'm with assistant principal, Miss Rucker, to show you your options for valograms. I would like to ask you a few questions.
Okay.
Is that okay?
That is perfectly fine.
What items are available for Valentine's Day?
So we have a variety of items that include suckers, bears, we have different types of cards, and chocolates.
How much does each item cost?
Each item ranges from a price of $1 to $3. Our suckers will be $1, and then our bears, which is the most expensive item, they will be about $3.
Can you give us a preview of what's included in the packages?
Sure. Here, set up on the table, we have a selection of stuffed animals. We have a selection of suckers. We have our different options for our Valentine's Day cards, chocolates, and our bracelets.
So, from what I'm hearing, can you customize your valogram?
Yes, you can choose any items that you want, and then we'll put it in a bag for you, and we will deliver it to your special loved one.
That's awesome. Okay, another question. Will you be planning on getting a valogram?
I don't know, I might. I might get somebody something, we'll see.
I hear there's gonna be a photo booth. Is that true? And if so, how much will it cost?
That is very true, and we're actually very excited about our photo booth this year. And each photo is going to be $1 or 4x6. So everybody who wants a copy will pay $1 to get a copy.
I love that. So you're saying if I have 5 friends, it costs $5, $1 from each?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Rucker, for being here today and letting me ask you these questions. Bye.
Bye.
But true!
True or false? Hippos have pink milk. False. Like all mammals, hippos produce white or off-white milk for their young. Despite this fact, it's easy to see where some of the color confusion comes from. Hippos have no actual sweat glands, but they do have mucus glands, which release an oily secretion frequently referred to as blood sweat. This reddish-colored sweat combined with white milk leads to the myth that hippos produce pink milk.
Hi, it's Markayla.
And Byron.
And today we're going to be exploring around Jefferson.
Jefferson, located approximately 40 miles east of Gilmer, hosted the 5th and 6th grade students. The boat tour gave students an up-close look at the importance of steamboats and trade in Jefferson's early history. Train rides and a trip to the general store rounded out the awesome day's adventure.
Here's a picture of a steamboat that came to Jefferson. As a matter of fact, there's two pictures. And they're loaded with bales of cotton. Those bales of cotton would weigh about 500 pounds. Hold up, like gunpowder being kept in that little brick building up ahead. Now that building was built during the Civil War, about 1863, they believe. During that Civil War, that war between the North and the South, the Yankees and the Rebels, they were making black gunpowder in Marshall, Texas. They would deliver it here by wagon and then the steamboat to pick it up on their way out of town. They didn't want it in town. Why?
Because that's
what
the war was
doing.
Why would you not want gunpowder in town?
Because if you shoot it, it goes...
It blew up! That's right! There were three of those buildings up there, but that's the only one that has survived from that Civil War period. Called a black powder magazine, or what the locals have always called the M.O. dump.
Molly Shark, Daddy Shark.
I'm here with Bailey, and we're inside of the general store about to get some fudge. I'm gonna ask her which one do you want the most, fudge or ice cream?
I like ice cream better.
I agree too.
Okay, so what is the favorite part of the trip so far for you?
Oh, this is probably the most.
The train. You should buy me.
Which are you excited more about, the fudge or the ice cream?
You should buy me this.
Oh,
fudge.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, guys, we're here at the general store. We've all gotten our ice cream. Some people are gift shopping, so after they're done, we're going to the park.
We're here with Miss Elwell. What do you think of the trip so far?
I've had a great time so far. We rode the train and we got to take a ride on the riverboat. That was a lot of fun.
What was your favorite part?
Well, I like riding on trains, so that was fun, but there were things I learned on the riverboat that I didn't know before.
So, what do you think of Jefferson so far?
I love Jefferson. I think it's beautiful and it's a great place to visit.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Haley.
And I'm Sophia.
We are here with Ms. Treadway today for GIS News.
Today we will be asking you 20 questions. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Would you rather wear sweaters in the summer or tank tops in the winter?
Tank tops in the winter.
Do you believe a hot dog is a sandwich?
No.
What would you consider your spirit animal?
What's your favorite subject?
Reading.
Would you rather read minds or see into the future?
See into the future. Reading minds is a dangerous thing.
What's your favorite color?
Red.
Would you rather spend the rest of your life swimming or running?
Swimming.
Do you have a favorite quote?
Yes, when you know better, you do better.
What time do you wake up in the morning?
5 a.m.
Would you rather have unlimited sushi or unlimited tacos for life?
Tacos. I do not like sushi.
If you were a candy bar, which one would you be?
Milky Way.
How long does it take you to get ready in the morning?
longer than I would like.
If you were in a circus, what would your job be?
The ringleader. Ringleader.
What's your favorite type of music?
I really like all kinds of music, but right now I'd say pop rock.
Who's your favorite performer?
Bon Jovi.
Would you rather be a mouse or a giraffe?
A mouse.
What's your favorite book?
I have a lot of favorite books. I like to read historical fiction. I like to read mystery, suspense, so I can't really give you a title. There's too many good ones out there.
What's your favorite hair band from the 80s?
Bon Jovi.
Why did you become a principal?
I wanted to make a difference.
In a survival situation, which teacher would you eat first?
I would eat the one that threatened my livelihood the most.
Ms. Treadway, thank you so much for joining us today and taking time out of your busy schedule.
Well, thank you for having me, ladies.
We appreciate all your hard work in keeping our school super cool.
Oh, thank you, girls.
Hey, GIS. Today we are here with Miss Alicia, our cafeteria manager.
About how many lunches do you serve daily?
For lunches daily, we serve anywhere from 280 to 300 students.
What are we having for lunch today?
Okay, today we will be having ham and cheese wraps, cheeseburgers, smiley fries, and salads.
Could you tell us about the coffee sweater?
Yes, ma'am. I can. This is the mixer that we use to make all our bowls with. We have a bowl and all the equipment that go in, and we just hook the bowl on here, turn it on, and it starts mixing.
What are you cooking for us today?
Some smiley fries.
What is the sweet treats for the teachers?
I prepare the sweet tea for them every day. But my most important sweet treats are for you children. I give y'all or sell y'all the ice creams and the chips and the Rice Krispies.
Your right hand on top. Now mop, yeah, mop. Left hand first. Now put your right hand on top. Now mop.
Yeah. Throw it up. Where you at?
Thank you for watching this episode of GIS News. Coming up in the future episodes, a tribute of Black History Month and the power of Peppa Pig.
Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all your social media.